Previously on, when vows are broken.
So baby, what do you think? Nice, right?
It has potentials, but I guess it will do for now.
Hey baby, do you feel like going get something to eat? Or maybe just eat out somewhere? I'm starving.
Sure babe. But can we even afford to eat out right now?
Baby, I got this. No worries.
And where did you get the money from, Dre? Last I remembered, you said that you were broke.
I borrowed the money from your mom. I'm sorry, baby, but I had to.
Dre, I told you don't be borrowing anything from my mom. Now she going to tell the whole congregation that her broke son-in-law can't provide for her only child. Don't do that again. Now let's just go and eat.
Sure. So honey, are you still mad at me?
Dre, just drive. I really don't feel like talking much right now.
So, are you ready to order, honey?
Yes, I'm ready.
Well, baby, are you ready to go? I'm getting really tired, especially after that long drive.
So are you a Christian, Jennifer?
Ma'am, what kind of question is that early this morning? That was about the weirdest conversation for our first time meet and greet. I met our neighbor. She seems interesting and very concerning to me.
Don't be like that, Jennifer. They probably ain't have neighbors in a long time, so let's just be nice, okay?
She seems a little off to me. Plus, I think the old lady has a thing for you.
Oh wait, someone has a crush on me. Call the cops.
But I have an interview today, so I need to get dressed right now.
When was you going to tell me about your interview, baby?
It's a dating service job. I help people find dates and all.
Wait, what? Baby, you couldn't find anything else other than that? You should have talked to me first about your options, honey. We are God-fearing people, and sometimes our jobs do defines who we really are without putting God first in our lives.
Dre, you sounding just like my mom right now.
Sir, are you all right? That's a fine young man, but he don't need to be with that wife of his. She seems no good for him.
Excuse me, do you know where I can find Mr. Choi at?
I'm dressed to impress, baby. I mean to get the job is what I meant.
So are you sure about this job?
Yes, I am sure about it. I mean, whatever pays the bills.
So I want to invite the both of you to my house for dinner one night, if you don't mind coming.
Wait, I don't clean anyone's toilet, Mr. Troy. That's gross. Is there anything else available?
But with the unemployment rate skyrocketing right now, anything is better than nothing at all.
I guess this isn't what I wanted to do, but I guess you are right, sir. Anything is better than nothing at all.
So are you interested?
Yes, I have no other choice right now. Between thinking of what to tell the wife, and that little prick, I'm about to lose it.
Are you all right, sir?
Lord, I don't want to lie to my wife, but I don't want to tell her about my job either.
Hey, babe, how was work? Did you start today or what? Tomorrow is a very important day for me.
And why is that, honey?
Because some billionaire is coming tomorrow, and wants to invest in our company.
She didn't ask about my work, so I didn't have to lie. But I'm happy for her. I'm just embarrassed that she is the breadwinner in this marriage.
I see the blessings coming our way. Blessings on blessings, yeah. I see the blessings coming our way.
Well, babe, it's time for me to head out. I'm so nervous right now.
Honey, don't be so nervous. You got this.
Dre, this is a big deal for that company. I hope I'm not the one that has to make conversation with that man. Dre, my nerves is so bad at this point.
Baby, calm down. Take a deep breath. Look, let's pray that all will go well.
Not right now, Dre. I will pray in the midst of it. But I have to go, babe. Love you.
Knock them dead, hun.
Okay, babe. Oh, and don't forget about dinner with our next door neighbors tonight, babe.
Yes, I totally forgot about that, honey.
I will be back home for 7 today, so be ready. Gotta go, babe.
Lord, please watch over my wife at work today. I may not like her job, Lord, but it's my job as her husband to support her in every way possible. Amen. Well, what should I get into today, since it's my day off?
Mom, what are you doing in here?
I sure miss your father. This was his favorite room in the whole house. Honey, your father loved to read so much, and he was a God-fearing man who loved the Lord with all his heart and soul, baby.
Mom, please don't cry. I wish that I would have met him before his passing. I will never know what a father figure feels like, I guess. But that's okay, because I have you, Mom, and that's all that matters to me.
Thank you, baby girl. I love you more than words could ever describe. You look so much like your father. Who would have thought we would have been blessed with you, my miracle child?
So, Mom, why didn't you just name me Miracle, since I'm your miracle child?
Before your father died, that's what I decided, but he wanted to name you after his grandmother, so that's how you got the name Sarah.
Okay, that's understandable. So why don't we start preparing for dinner tonight? I have to go get a few things at the store. Are you coming?
Sure, honey. I need to air out a bit.
Okay, Mom. Let's go.
Hello, so Mrs. Jennifer, as you know that today we have a big-time billionaire coming to our office, you should be arriving soon. So I have made my decision to have you working with him, answering all his questions, communicating at your highest level. We need this investment girl. But, why me? There are others that been here way longer than I have. I'm not sure I'm fit for the job with a person with that type of money, ma'am. Look, I understand that you are nervous, but you are past fit for the job, Jennifer. I've seen your resume, and I also seen all the others as well, and none of them is more qualified than you are. Well, I will do my best, Miss Tori. That's all I can promise to you. Please make it count. This could be big, and plus more money for you and others. Well, I will call you in my office when he arrives. Have a good day, Mrs. Jennifer. Okay, ma'am.
Sir, where are you heading?
I'm headed to the port.
Okay, to the port it is.
So, honey, what do you think our neighbors would like to eat?
I never thought of that, but I'm pretty sure whatever we hook up would be fine. Besides, it's a free meal.
I guess you're right. Well, let's start looking for something.
Okay, Mom.
Okay, sir. We are pulling up to the port.
Thank you. How much do I owe you for the cab ride, sir?
It's free of charge, sir.
Wait, what? Why shouldn't I pay you for this ride?
Because that still small voice spoke to me and told me not to charge you a penny. So, sir, your ride is on me today.
Oh, wow. Thank you, sir. I really appreciate this. The good Lord will surely bless you for this.
Son, I don't do it for the blessings, because the Lord is always good to me. It's my job to help others. Now you have a blessed day, sir.
Thank you again, and you have a blessed day also.
Well, let me call my daughter and see how her and the husband is doing. Oh, but she ain't answering my calls, I see. Let me call her husband.
Hello, this Dre speaking.
Well, hello, son-in-law. What? You and my daughter forgot I was still alive.
Oh, hey, Ma, how have you been out there?
I've been good. Where is my daughter? And why isn't she answering any of my calls, Dre?
Your daughter is at work. She gets off at about 7. But we're having dinner with our neighbors as soon as she gets back. So you might want to call her tomorrow when she may have time to talk.
Oh, but she can have dinner with her neighbors, but not call her mom since you both moved out there. I feel like an outcast. What type of work my daughter does? Since I'm left in the dark.
Well, she works at a matchmaking company where they find people dates that are compatible with each other.
Oh no, Lord Jesus, take me now, O Lord. My daughter is working for the devil. Have mercy on her soul, Lord. I rebuke him in Jesus' almighty name. Please save my daughter from eternal damnation, Lord. Dre, how could you allow my daughter, your wife, to work at a place like that? My daughter was raised in a church. She wasn't supposed to be working at Satan's Den. What type of husband are you? I thought you were better than that, Dre.
Miss Tammy, I'm sorry, but I don't like it either. But bills have to be paid, regardless of our occupation. Maybe it's just a start until something better comes along. I don't know, but whatever God has in store for me and my wife, then we gon' have to accept what we have now, until the Lord gives us something better. I mean, you should know about the struggles, Miss Tammy.
Look, nice speech and all, but my daughter won't be hooking up people to fornicate with each other. That is a sinful place, Dre. And I will not, and I do mean not, allow my one and only daughter to work at the devil house, while her so-called husband allow her to.
Look, Miss Tammy, I have to go. You calm down and have a blessed day. Bye. That woman is crazy. I will pray for her. That's all I can do.
Oh, but he had some nerves hanging the phone up in my face like that. I have news for him and my daughter. I will pack up and head out there. They will be shocked to see me. I'm not letting them know anything.
Miss Tori, there is a Mr. Mike here to see you. Should I let him in?
Sure, Tina. And can you call Jennifer in my office as well? Thank you.
Sure, ma'am. Sir, you may go in now. Mrs. Jennifer, Miss Tori wants you in her office.
Okay, thanks. Okay, Jennifer, get it together, girl. You got this. How are you doing, Mr. Mike?
I'm doing pretty good. I can't complain.
That's good to know. Well, so did you consider investing in my company?
I'm still considering it, but I need to know a little bit more about your company before dumping lots of money into it, if that's okay with you.
That's fine with me. One of my employees will be helping you make a decision. She will be in shortly.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, Jennifer, this handsome young man behind you is looking to find a lot of answers as to how we do things around here. Take notes, please. Okay, madam. Is something the matter? Do you both know each other or something? No, we don't know each other. I thought I did, but totally different person. Sorry. Okay, why don't you and Mr. Mike go and get acquainted in your office? Answer any questions he has. Okay. Thank you again, Mike, and Jennifer will be assisting you throughout this process, and I will assure you that you won't regret it. If you decide to invest in my company, you are in good hands, sir.
Thank you very much. Well, let's get this show on the road.
You got it. Jennifer, can I speak to you for a moment? Sure. Please don't let me down in the company. I know you got this, girl. But a word of advice, be careful, okay? I won't let you down, and you have nothing to worry about. Okay, you may go now.
Okay, are we going to get started, Miss Jennifer?
Why, sure, I'm sorry. Are you looking for a date?
I'm actually in between relationships right now.
Okay, so you could use our services, right?
Well, I like getting dates the old way, if you know what I mean. Jennifer.
Yes, I know what you mean, and it's Mrs. Jennifer. Thank you.
Okay, please don't bite my head off, Mrs. Jennifer.
It's fine, let's just finish up. Okay.
I don't know how I feel about all this.
Excuse me?
I'm not sure this is something I should be investing in, you know.
Well, it's totally up to you. It's your money. Do what you feel, and listen to your heart.
What do you think I should do? Should I take that leap of faith, or just move on to something else?
Just try it out and see, you never know. To me it's just some old guys paying to meet women, but I can tell you what to do. But give it a shot and see.
Okay, I will, because more than half of all new relationships are started online in this new generation anyways.
That is so true, of course you would know.
She definitely has something going here. I'm just trying to figure out what and how I fit into it.
That's why I'm here. To help you figure that out. I have some questionnaire that I out together, and pretty much we use it to see whether or not Simeon's compatible. You'll see the compatibility questionnaire, we will start with that, and see where that goes.
Okay, sounds good to me.
Finally made it back home, what an awkward day. Well, my baby will be back home in a few, I don't feel like going anywhere, but my word is my word.
What time they was coming, sweetheart?
Should be in about another hour or so.
Okay, that was a lots of food we cooked. I hope it all don't go to waste.
It won't, because they probably will take some with them.
Good, I can't wait for you to meet that woman husband, he's such a gentleman. Oh honey, did I tell you that he gave me a ride to the store when I was going to walk there? Such a polite young man to be with someone like her.
Mom, don't start, I'm sure he is nice, but that's my friend husband.
Honey, I know that, I didn't mean anything by that, just that you going to like him, he is a kind sweet soul.
Sure mom. I'm sure I will, I'm going to set the table.
Honey, we eating in here tonight, I want to be comfortable.
Okay mom, if that's what you want.
You back, so, did you decide yet?
Yes, it took a lots of convincing, but I decided to invest in your company.
Great, thank you so much. So on Tuesday, can you come in to do a lots of paperwork and get this all finalized?
Yes, I sure can, but I have to run, I have business to attend to.
Sure, sure, I don't want to hold you up or anything, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yes. Why are you still here?
Because I was waiting on you to come out.
For what? This is strictly business.
No, I'm not going anywhere until you agree to meet me so we can talk.
Excuse me. Talk about what? We don't have anything to talk about, Mike. Like I said, this was strictly business, nothing more, nothing less.
Look, you either agree to meet up and talk, or I'm pulling out this deal with this company. Now do I make myself clear, Jennifer?
So, is that a threat, Mike?
No, it's more like a demand. So what's it going to be?
Sure, whatever.
How about tomorrow at the Forest Village? About 4 p.m. and don't be late.
Yeah, whatever. Bye. Before someone sees me. Why, just why, is my past coming back to me, Lord? What have I done so wrong? Jennifer, are you alright? Oh, I'm sorry. I was just thinking about how it's a blessing that you picked me for that client. Well, you did your thing, and now it's money, money, money for this company, thanks to you, girl. You should be proud of yourself. Oh, trust me, I am. Well, I better be going. Dinner with my neighbors tonight, like in a few. I will see you on Monday. Okay, girl, I hope you all enjoy your evening, and thanks again.
I hear my baby pulling up. Hey, baby. How was your day?
It went awesome, babe. We got the investment.
Baby, I'm happy for you. So did you get the position to deal with this rich guy?
Yes, I couldn't believe it. So now we are getting pay raises.
I knew you could do it, honey. It was the good Lord that blessed you, along with prayers.
Thanks, babe.
Oh, and your mama called. She wasn't too happy.
And why she wasn't happy? Please don't tell me that she told her where I work, Dre.
Baby, you know I can't lie to that woman. She can see straight through me. She asked why you wasn't answering her calls. I said that you was at work, that she asked me about it.
Oh my goodness, Dre. Now she will be flying over here, all in our business.
I'm sorry, baby, but you should have called and check up on her.
I was, Dre, when I had the time, but let's go. I'm already tired as is.
Okay, baby.
Come on in, handsome.
How you doing, Miss Maria?
Aw, baby, I'm doing real good.
You met my wife before?
Yes, I did.
Hello.
Well, we meet again, after all this time.
Yes, I guess so.
Well, don't be a stranger, go and eat, my daughter is in the kitchen.
Okay, thanks.
Well, I hope they enjoy.
Hey girl.
Girl, I was worried about you, so how did it go at work? Did you all get the investor to invest?
Yes, girl, easy peasy. Now let the money start rolling in.
Girl, I'm happy for you.
Thanks, I appreciate that so much, chick.
No problem. So, where is that husband of yours? I want to meet him.
Girl, he was just talking to your mom, but he's in your living room if you want to meet him. I'm starving and ready to eat.
Okay, well help yourself, girl. I will go introduce myself. Dre.
Sarah.
Well, I didn't know you were Jennifer's husband, Dre. What a small world.
Yes, I am. And I didn't know you were my neighbor daughter. It sure is a small world.
It's okay, now that we got that out the way. So, how is you liking the job so far?
Besides that little annoying kid, I guess it's all right for now.
Oh, you mean Damien? He is a good kid once you get to know him.
So, that's what I've been told.
Well, I will let you get back to eating your food. I hope that you enjoy it, Dre.
Yes, it's real good. Thanks for the invite, Sarah.
No problem. Girl, you still in this kitchen?
Yes, because I'm too full to move.
Okay then, girl, why didn't you tell me that Dre was your man?
Why do you ask that? Do you know Dre already?
Dre is a janitor where I work. He never told you?
Dre told me he started working, but I didn't know where and what position. But of course I never asked his position, and he never bothered bringing it up to me.
Okay, then, maybe I shouldn't have told you, but I seriously thought you knew. And besides, I barely know him, but from work.
It's okay, Sarah, you done nothing wrong, girl. I just wished that he would have told me what he do at his job. And not try to keep it from me.
Well, again I'm sorry, maybe he was too embarrassed to tell you. I don't know, girl.
Chick, it's okay, no worries at all, and I mean it. But we're going to get going, I'm exhausted from work and all. I had a really nice time, and the food was on point.
Why, thank you.
Babe, I'm ready to go. Please say your goodbyes, I will walk on.
Honey, I will walk with you. Give me a second, please.
Dre, we just stay across from them. I will be waiting at home for you if you decides to stay for a bit.
Okay, baby. See you in just a few minutes.
I guess these old bones is ready for bed.
Well, Miss Maria, good night. I really enjoyed myself, and the cooking was so good.
Well, thank you, sweetheart. I appreciate the compliment. Don't be a stranger, son. Good night.
Good night. Hey, I was coming to fix me a plate to go.
Go ahead, Dre, and help yourself to whatever you want.
Thank you. Well, I better be going. My wife left without me. She seems a little on edge.
Dre, did you ever tell Jennifer what you do for a living?
No, not yet. Why do you ask?
Because when we was talking, I told her I knew you from work, and that you were a janitor. I had no idea she didn't know what you did, Dre. I'm so sorry.
What?
I'm sorry, I told her.
It's okay, Sarah. That's not your fault. Eventually I would have told her.
Bray, are you ashamed of what you do? Because it's alright. Things will get better like I told you before.
Sarah, I'm not ashamed of what I do, it's just that I don't want to be judged by my own wife for not having a high-paying job like she expects me to have.
I understand, Bray. Just hold on, and have faith in the plans God has for you. God put you in that position only temporary, until everything falls in place. So be patient.
Words of encouragement. How do you do it, Sarah? You make me feel confident in myself.
Well, we all need a shoulder to cry on, and good friend that will listen. God first in your life, and He will put people in your life that won't tear you down, but lift you up. So don't beat yourself up, Dre.
I appreciate you, Sarah. I really do. Now I better be going. I will talk to you later.
Okay, Dre. Good night.
Thanks. Welp, I guess I have to face the music.